My name is Eleanor Sawyer, and I'm presenting to you about the Care of Older People Clinical Network's NPJ Paralysis Victoria project. I'd like to start by acknowledging the traditional owners of all of the lands which we are on. I'm on the Boon Wurrung land of the Kulin Nation, and I pay my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging, and the elders from other communities who may be here today. NPJ paralysis is all about valuing people's time. I'm going to talk to you about why we need to end PJ paralysis, the project structure, interventions, results, and sustainability. PJ paralysis. It's not a rare neurological disease, but a phrase coined on Twitter regarding the lack of movement that occurs when patients remain in their pajamas. NPJ paralysis is an online campaign that began in 2017 in the UK and has since spread across the world to prevent the deleterious physical and psychological impact of hospital stays on patients. To engage teams to join our project, we needed to be very clear about the why for NPJ paralysis. Bed rest is bad. It causes multi-system damage, including musculoskeletal damage, including muscle loss, contractures, and reduced range of motion, cardiovascular damage, leading to decreased VO2 max, respiratory damage, including atelectasis and pooling of secretions, skin damage, leading to skin necrosis after 2 hours, and other system impact, including gastrointestinal, genitourinary, and cognitive changes. All of this causing functional decline. Patients leave hospital worse than they arrived. Victoria sent out a call to arms to see who was interested in collaborating to end PJ paralysis. The sites were required to recruit a project team, including a project lead, an executive sponsor, a nurse unit manager sponsor, clinical champions, and a consumer. The most effective teams were multidisciplinary, with visible executive endorsement, and had clinicians on the ground. When recruiting clinicians, consider staff who are excited about improvement and can mobilise others to change. These might include the new graduate nurse or the junior rotating physio. We had sites from all across Victoria submit teams, including 9 regional, 10 rural, and 14 metropolitan hospitals. There were 35 hospital wards, ranging in size from 4 to 40 beds, with large acute medical or surgical wards, rehabilitation wards, all the way through to the small rural wards. We held 4 collaborative workshops to support this project, where teams shared their ideas, tips, and tricks, and learned about different tools to help support the implementation of their ideas on their ward. At each of the workshops, we introduced additional theory about the model for improvement, had exercises to generate ideas, and opportunities to share challenges and how they had been overcome. We then had action periods in between, where teams would use rapid plan, do, study, act cycles to test and implement changes on their wards. We had an online call in between each workshop to share learnings, ask and answer questions. I travelled from Terang to Terlangana, South Gippsland to Sale, Warwick Nabil to Wodonga, and everywhere in between. Every site received a visit from SEV within the first 3 months to support the commencement of their program. To overcome the geographical challenges of ongoing visits across the state, at the 3 month mark, sites categorised themselves according to how much support they wanted. The Tier 1 sites received at least one more visit, Tier 2 sites received visits if requested, and Tier 3 sites did not receive additional visits. We used the model for improvement for this project, and the teams collected data on these measures, including the number of patients who mobilised per day, were dressed in everyday clothes, and who sat out of bed for lunch per day. The teams then used plan, do, study, act sequences to test the changes under a variety of conditions before implementing successful changes. The teams tested numerous ideas, and the successful interventions included promotion, including a launch with staff in pyjamas. Teams developed posters to display around the ward and pamphlets to give to patients. Northern Health even translated the posters into 12 different languages. The teams used visual management boards to communicate to staff and patients about their project. It was also a great way to demonstrate improvements with their data. In order to encourage mobility and sitting out of bed for lunch, a number of environmental modifications were made. These included racetracks where the numbers of metres walked were clearly defined, and a walking track with iconic Melbourne locations on the ward walls. All of the teams decluttered the visitor rooms to encourage patients and their families to walk and sit down. Some teams played music in the room, others had magazines and games to play. One team created a cognition board with newspapers, crosswords and Sudokus available to take. It encouraged patients to walk up to the board and take something to do back to their rooms. Many teams audited their equipment and found that they didn't have sufficient chairs for patients to sit out of bed in, or there were insufficient gait aids to use. This was an easy capital spend prior to the end of the financial year. Education was integral to the success of this project. It included ward in services, grand rounds, and patient education. One of the geriatricians involved, Amelia Crabtree, created a patient book highlighting the importance of getting dressed and moving to get home. A large problem identified by the sites was patients arriving to the hospitals with only their pyjamas. This was overcome by creating clothes space where staff donated clothes for patients, or creating relationships with op shops, and also alerting patients to the need to wear everyday clothes on the ward in pre-admission pamphlets. It was absolutely critical to engage consumers in this project. This is an example from West Gippsland Health Service of a consumer video developed to engage the staff in their project. The last lady was a 94-year-old patient who was desperate to be included in the video, so the team decided to keep her in despite her soft volume.
You're so used to getting dressed every day. And if you don't get dressed, well, you must be sick. So by getting dressed, it's giving people the idea that you're not sick. You're on your way to recovery.
Fantastic.
So I think that is the best thing about getting dressed. It gives you a clear mind, and clear mind gives you better health. So I think that, I think everyone, no matter how long they've got to spend in hospital, should get up every morning, have a shower, get dressed, and start the new day. You feel that much better, that you're not just stuck in your pyjamas or something like that, and you've made the move to get dressed and take on a new day. It just sort of sets you back straight away, as if I'm ill, you know, and there's not much can be done about it. But if you get up and get dressed, it's starting the day off afresh. And I think it gets you home that much quicker too.
I like to get up and dressed and moving in the hospital, because I know walking makes you feel better. And just get out, up and out. Start to feel great because it's the beginning of the day and I can go for a walk. If I go out through one of the doors, I can hear birds singing and see the bush and see the sky, and if you're walking, you might meet a friend on the way and things. And
so when's good? When you get dressed, are you more likely to walk?
Definitely. Just get up and go.
And do you think when you get dressed, it makes you feel better in yourself?
Yes. Up and dressed. That you can get out and go for a walk. Not lie in bed and do not very much.
And how do you feel when you wear the pyjamas in hospital, you know, with the open backs?
Not me. That's not me. I just like getting up and dressed.
And it helps. I guess it's part of your normal routine, isn't it?
Yes. just get up and get dressed and feel alive. It makes you feel alive. Get up, get dressed, move.
Are we ready? Edna, can you tell us why you want to get dressed every day? You feel better. It's a good thing. Yeah. What's your message to other people who want to stay in their pajamas? Don't do it. Why is that?
Make the effort and get dressed.
Make the effort and get dressed. Yeah. Thanks, Edna. Thank you.
Here at West Gippsland Healthcare Group, we want to end PJ paralysis by getting patients up, dressed and moving. What we wear influences how we feel, our feelings and our identity and our behaviour. Encouraging our patients to wear their own day clothes helps them maintain dignity and feel better. We know patients feel better in their own clothes, and this helps them in the recovery process. In fact, the number of days in hospital decreases when normal routine is encouraged. Help us help patients get up, get dressed, get moving, and end PJ paralysis.
Along with posters and pamphlets on the ward, ongoing promotion occurred in a number of unique ways. There were mascots. You can see PJ on the right, who is located at a rural hospital in Victoria and is known to dance in the visitor lounge. And then there was social media. Rural Northwest Health developed the YouTube clip, I Want to Break Free from My PJs, which you can Google. And of course there was Twitter. I visited every site across Victoria and tweeted my way around the state. I even managed to get Channel 9 attention, which was a great way of communicating the benefits of this program to the community. So what did we see? There was a 19% increase in the median number of patients getting dressed and mobilising per day, and a 16% increase in the median number of patients sitting out of bed for lunch per day. There was a decrease in length of stay, falls and pressure injuries in high-performing sites. There was also a significant increase in self-rated quality improvement knowledge and capability in participants, and increased professional connections both within and between health services. And we learned a lot about collaboration. Regional sites found it helpful to have a closer workshop and to network with similar sized wards. Virtual collaboration between the workshops was helpful to share successes and learnings. But virtual collaboration needed to be all or nothing. Our hybrid model of in-person and virtual workshops at the same time just really didn't work. A few sustainability tips and tricks are to involve all of the multidisciplinary team, come up with a variety of change ideas and help disperse the project load, increase ownership of the project across the ward. Some wards were really enthusiastic and started with a launch and tested a number of change ideas at once, but then lost the enthusiasm and the data dropped down after a couple of weeks. The wards that staggered the interventions over time found that there was improved sustainability. Sites found it improved accountability when they had to regularly report to an executive sponsor or a hospital committee. Education in a number of formats was also important so that all staff were aware of the new way. It was also obviously important for patients and families to try and change the bed rest culture. Requiring the changes into ward processes such as orientation of new staff and admission processes also helped to embed the changes. And finally, have fun. Embrace the quirks of your ward and unique ideas. There are so many great ideas that can be found on YouTube and Twitter, just like this next YouTube clip by Caulfield Hospital. Thank you.
party hard, it's like it's Mardi Gras, cause that's what life is for. And we don't party hardly, we just party hard. And not because we bored, we party cause we born a party. We gon' move our bodies with our hands in the air and wave them all around like we just don't care. I like them more and more, I like them more and more, I like them more and more, we like to move it. I like the more and more, she like the more and more, we like the more and more, we like the more. So I can do my little dance, do my little dance, do my little, do my little, do my little dance. Ants in my pants, got ants in my pants, ants in my, ants in my, ants in my pants. That's why, keep on, yes, that's why, keep on, yes, that's why, keep on doing, doing what I'm doing, y'all. I like the more and more, I like the more and more, I like the more and more, we like the more. I like the more and more, she like the more and more, we like the more and more, we like the more. Somebody say ho, say ho. Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. Yo, somebody say yeah. Say yeah, yeah. Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. Back it up, 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 back it up. Give me room, give me room, car. I like the more and more. I like the more and more. I like the more and more. We like the she like to shake it, shake it. She like to shake it, shake it. She like to shake it, shake it. Yeah, shake it, girl. We like to party, party. We like to party, party. We like to party, party. We like to party. We like to move it, move it. He like to move it, move it. They like to move it, move it. Move it, move it, move it, move it, move it.
Here are my details if you would like to contact me with any questions about this project. Thank you very much.